Three-parent in vitro fertilization is a technique intended to prevent diseases caused by defective genes located in mitochondria. Because a donor egg is needed, as well as genetic information from a mother and a father, the resulting baby will technically have three parents. The vast majority of the DNA makeup of the child will come from the mother and the father, but since another woman's egg was used, it contains a handful of her genes in the mitochondria of that cell. The process involves exchanging an egg cell that contains defects in mitochondrial genes with a cell from a donor that does not contain those defective genes. Once the donor egg cell is secured, it's then a matter of introducing the genetic material from the mother and the father. There are two similar yet slightly different methods for this. One is called a maternal spindle transfer. The other is called a pronuclear transfer. In the maternal spindle transfer procedure, the genetic information from a mitochondrial defect-free donor egg is removed. Then, the genetic information from a mother with mitochondrial gene defects is inserted. In this way, a woman with harmful genes in her mitochondrial cells is able to place her genetic information into an egg that is free of the defective genes. This egg is then fertilized by sperm from the father. The resulting embryo contains the father's DNA, the mother's DNA, and a small amount of DNA from the third donor inside the mitochondria of the cell. The pronuclear transfer method is a slightly different method of getting to the same endpoint. An embryo with the mother and father's DNA in a cell that has mitochondria free of any defective genes. With this method, standard IVF techniques are used to create an embryo. The mother's egg is fertilized by the father's sperm, forming a 2-pronuclear zygote. This very early embryo contains maternal mitochondria with defective genes. Here, the parental DNA exists in the form of a pair of pronuclei inside the cell. The next step is to remove the pronuclei from the cell and transfer them to a donor cell that has had the pronuclei removed. This donor cell contains mitochondria, which is free of defects. In the end, the pronuclei from the mother and father are transferred to the donor cell. The resulting zygote contains the father's DNA, the mother's DNA, and a small amount of DNA from a third donor inside the mitochondria of the cell.